Okay, I've just come out of Madame X, her third performance of the whole tour, in Brooklyn. The Howard Gilman Opera House, I think, part of BAM. My shirt says Madonna in Hebrew. This was my outfit. I wore this shirt so that she could see her own name. Actually, this way, her own name. And I wore these shorts so that she could see my giant Homsons. It was an amazing, amazing show. Oh, and I wore this just because I thought it would be like, you know, eye-catching. We were third row, near the center, slightly house right. And at one point she, you know, there were no phones, and boy, was that liberating. Oh my God, I mean, I couldn't wait to get mine back and make this post, but it was very liberating to not have it. And she took a selfie of herself with a Polaroid film camera and said, this is the only image of this tonight. It's gonna get so much money. You know, it's so valuable. Who wants to buy it for me? And, you know, people went up there, and this guy dressed like, I actually got a picture with him, his name's Mark, who was dressed like the American Life video in the general's outfit. He gave her like all the money in his pocket. It was like 13 bucks. She's like, no, I want serious coin. And I eventually went up there and I took this out and I held it up. I got 2 meters away from her, less, a meter and a half. And which side do I want? Okay. Wait, NR, oh shit. Fuck, I went the queue. Oh, hold on a minute. Never mind, I only had to just turn around. Same station though. A cute little dog here. Woof, woof, woof. Anyway, so I was gonna give her my hat and say to her, this is worth more than money. It's a Bukharian kippah, which is a Persian style yarmulke, made by, you know, in the style of Jews who lived in what is modern day Iran. And it was made in Russia in 1950. It still has the tag on it. And I bought it in Jerusalem, and it's very, very valuable to me, and I love it. And I don't even want the selfie that much, Madonna. And I definitely don't want to give up the kippah, but I would, not for the selfie, for this moment I'm having interacting with you. That's priceless. And I want to say that. So I was going to say that to her. But I didn't get the chance because some bitch in front of me gave her $1,000. And apparently that did the ticket. Hey, I guess she was making a statement about capitalism or something. So, three of her children, at least I could tell, were in it. Esther and, oh my God, what's Esther's twin or sister's name? Can't remember, sorry. And Mercy was in it. Lola was in it by video. In the box, on the side, Bono was there, sitting next to Guy Osiri. And we were like, hi, Bono. What else do I want to say? So, and then another time I got super close. First of all, at one point, you know, she talks a lot, does a lot of jokes, and it's very intimate. And at one point, she talked about dancing or being tired. She said, I bet you get more sleep than me. And she said, like, what are some idioms or expressions, you know, about sleeping? And someone else said, no rest for the wicked or for the weary. I forget how that one goes. And then I yelled one out. Actually, the same one, a guy behind me yelled it out at the same time. We both said, I'll sleep when I'm dead. And she said, what? Because I think we were talking at the same time. It was muddled a little bit. And then we got in sync and we both said it together. I'll sleep when I'm dead. And she said, I don't think she's read Many Lives, Many Masters. Because she said, actually, I won't. When I'm dead, hopefully I'll be reborn and reincarnated. And you will, what are you guys looking for?
We're going to be trying to go to, we're trying to go to Church Avenue.
So you, Church and what?
Church.
Yeah, okay, so you want to take the Q train and
right
get off of church. Yeah.
Right here?
Yeah, right here.
On this side?
On this side. Right, you're in the right place.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome. So, where was I?
Right.
And so we said that, and she said, She said, I'm not going to sleep when I'm dead. I'm going to be reborn and reincarnated. And she's like, hopefully you'll be there too. But I don't think she's read Many Lives, Many Masters, because that kind of talks about that you do get reincarnated until you reach the stage where in your lifetime, you're a teacher. And then you, it's not that your energy dies, but you don't come back to Earth to live a human life. You do like whatever's next, like some really cool shit. And obviously Madonna's doing that. So actually, Aaron, if you're watching this, buy Many Lives, Many many Masters for Madonna and read that. Actually, read it yourself. So then for another part of the show, she came over and sat. We were in the third row. She sat in the first row, two or three seats to our right and two rows in front of us. Again, I was like 2 meters away from her. And she looked so pretty. And okay, now songs. Frozen was amazing. She did this stuff with a giant video. By the way, I guess I should have said there's lots of spoilers in this. She did a giant video of, turns out it was Lola, behind her, and she was on a riser behind it, and she played with scale. And so Madonna's choreography, which was seated and a lot of like this stuff like this. Well, it was, this is my train. Yep, this is my train. I'm not gonna talk on the train. I'll to be continued in a sec. Actually, what the hell, I will talk. I guess I could be quiet. There's some queens watching me, you know. So she had a conversation with a guy who had a full beer. We weren't really part of that, but we were very, very close to it, and it was very intimate. And it was interesting, my friend Sheila noticed that they took the beer away, even though it was the guy's beer. They took it when she left. You know why, I think? DNA. Like, if he had that, you could fucking clone her. So they took it away from that. Oh, I need to see the set list in front of me. I also thought Extreme Oxidant was awesome. And you know what? I don't really care for Batuka on the record, even though I know it's like, in a sense, Batuka's like the heart of the album because of those women and this the history of this music, an unbroken chain of this call and response music, Batuka. But I liked it. But, I can, I'm excited. I just saw Madame X. So this guy wants me to be quiet. He's like, I can hear from here. Yeah, you know, all right, I'm trying to be quiet. I don't want to pick a fight with him. So I'm gonna go out to here. That's how we deal with that. So I actually really liked Human Nature a lot. She does that song a lot, but it was a cool version. It was like a jazz version. It was very liberating not having my phone. Oh, merchandise. I did very, very good. I spent about $200, maybe a little less. I got a hoodie sweatshirt. I got a t-shirt. I got patch, which I'm gonna iron on my marathon shirt. I got, they didn't have coffee mugs. I got a baseball hat. They didn't have belt buckles. And then I went back and I got a sleep mask because that'll be cool. You know, it's got that X. I would never want to get the actual patch because, you know, thank God I have sight in both eyes. And I know it's just a look, but I don't want to do anything that takes away any of my eyesight. But a sleep mask, well, you're sleeping, so it doesn't. Anyway, for me, the highlight was Extreme Oxidant. Frozen was like my favorite number. I liked Killers Who Are Partying a lot. I liked Batuka, which I don't really like on the record. I liked Come Alive. I liked Future as a ballad. And you can really concentrate on the lyrics more. The audience was very cool and international. I can't wait to take Boaz there. For the first time in December in Philadelphia. So it was an amazing show. I'm so wound up. I did really great with merch. I had a great time. We had great seats. everyone behaved, everyone was polite, everyone was sitting and dancing and together as a group, you know, whether, oh, should we sit down for the song? Oh, should we stand up for the song? And the thing with the phones was great. It was so nice to not have it. I have to say, for real, for real. I said the Shehecheyanu before we went, because I just felt it was such a blessing to reach this date and be able to go see the concert. Thank you, God, for getting so close to Madonna. And she was performing so wonderfully, really giving so much. Oh, the James Baldwin quote about how it's painful for everyone to be alive, but what you have to do, the trick about like being an artist, or not the trick, but being an artist is about finding a way to connect with other people, because we're all feeling that pain. But then she says it's to disturb the peace, which is interesting because connecting with other people brings me peace. So I'm not really sure about that. But James Baldwin. And, oh, you know what? I saw something on Lola's skin in the video where, does she have all her brothers and sisters' names tattooed on her? That kind of made me think that, oh, maybe I'll get like some family members, like a little, but I would get them as like a crossword puzzle. Interesting, perhaps. So I had an inspiration of a new tat. I loved my outfit. I was so comfortable. What can I tell you? Go see Madam X. It was, I think it was the greatest Madonna show I've ever been to, because it was so nice being so close to her. And boy, I mean, she rocks stadiums, she rocks arenas, but the theater really suits her. She really, really knows what to do with that space. Okay. Shabbat shalom, everyone. Have a great weekend. Bye. Oh, that reminds me. She didn't sing, I'll be Israel if they're incarcerated. She changed it to Palestine, which is fine. But she sang the lyric of Islam and then Palestine. So, you know, there wasn't anything Jewish in that song. But that's fine. Actually, it was good because my expectations. I had some expectations so that's a little mini lesson there about, you know, that expectations breed resentment, or, you know, they're not always good things, expectations. And I bet you she mixes it up in some shows. She sings Palestine, in some shows she sings Israel. And oh, a lot of the people that she talked to were like, oh yeah, I'm going to many, many shows more. And fuck, I can't go to more. I mean, I'm going to one more, but like, I don't know how people afford like those seats close up, many, many, many more. I can't. All right, thanks for watching all this. Love you, Shabbat Shalom. Oh, also, she went on at 10:40. Oop, hold on, my dog's pooping. I like to play a game sometimes of like, guess what time she's gonna come on. So, you know, the tickets say 8:30. The venue said 9:30, but apparently in practice she was going on around 10:30. But Sheila had some bad intel, and she thought it was 9:30. So we got there like a little after 9. She went on at 10:40. Anyway, I picked 10:14. The guy next to me had 10:05, Mark. Sheila had 10:20. Anyway, this guy who wasn't even playing with us, he was in the front row and he heard us, and he yelled at like, oh, 10:50. Apparently he won. And she mentioned that. She said maybe in the next life she won't be like so tardy. And she says, hey, it's hard. She says she needs to take breaks because she's 60. I think she said that. And she said also that she has 6 kids. She mentioned an injury, and I guessed that. She was wearing black sports tape on her left thigh. Now, she made it rock and roll or punk rock. She put probably an unnecessary piece across, like making it into a cross, like crucifix, like, you know, very Madonna. But I was just like, that looks like athletic, that muscular healing tape that athletes use. And she referenced an injury, so yep, must have been that. Scotty P called it.